In this guide I will explain the procedure to activate ADB ROOT on a stock firmware on KaiOS and Android. This procedure carries a double risk. The loss of official updates, resolvable. The rupture of the device, often irreversible. Proceed at your own risk. What is the firmware? In computing, firmware is a specific class of computer's software that provides the low-level control for the device's specific hardware. Firmware can either provide a standardized operating environment for the device's more complex software, allowing more hardware independence, or, for less complex devices, act as the device's complete operating system, performing all control, monitoring and data manipulation functions. Firmware is held in non-volatile memory devices such as ROM, EPROM, or flash memory. Changing the firmware of a device is nowadays a common procedure. Some firmware memory devices are permanently installed and cannot be changed after manufacture. Common reasons for updating firmware include fixing bugs or adding features to the device. Why is it so risky to replace the firmware? Replacing the original firmware with a custom one is a huge plus. In case of errors, the device can incur in the best of cases a continuous reboot, but even there is the risk of not being able to turn on anymore. Get a copy of your stock boot. If you don't have a certified boot.tim for your KaiOS Android device on the internet, take it using the shell. Use a temporary root access on your device and perform DD from ADB shell. How to enable ADB ROOT on your custom firmware. 1. Create a new folder and put your boot.m there, with this rooted ADBD binary file. This one comes from GERDOS. To open a terminal into the new folder and perform the following commands. We will do the operation in 3 blocks, just like the previous guide about recovery mode, but the B block changes. A. In this way you extract the boot.img and the internal init.img that contains the essential files. A boot.img xboot.img. A boot.img unpack and enter. B1, with these commands you remove the stock ADBD binary in /ram/disk/spin/ and replace it with a new one. RE/ram/disk/spin/ind. CP/ram/disk/spin/ind. B2, now you have to edit the default.prop file in this main folder. CP/ram/disk/default.prop. Use a text editor and change the following values. Row.debuggable must be 1, in this way the device is able to use debug. Row.add.secure must be 0, needed to enable ADB. Now push again the default.prop file in its place. RE/ram/disk/default.prop. CP/default.prop/ram/disk/default.prop. With these commands, you remove an .dim from the main folder, repack the new one, and rewrite it in boot.dim. rm an .dim. A boot dim pack an enter. Otim view boot.dim gar an .dim. Warning. You should get an error like this. Boot.dim updated is too big for the boot image. Max value versus min value bytes. Then get max value and launch this last command. botim.u.boot.imgar.net.imc boot size equals max value. Now your custom firmware is finally ready to be flashed. Thanks for your attention. See you next. BananaHackers.net. Join the revolution.